Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Delhi Tarot, and these are your monthly readings for the Sun, Moon and the rising sign of Leo. Leo, please keep in mind that this is your group general reading for the month of June. Since it's a group reading, so please pick it up what resonates with you. Please leave the rest for others. And if you really like what I do on the channel, please do like, subscribe the channel and put on the notifications. For any personal private reading, my email ID, my website is mentioned in the description box below. And please keep in mind that all personal private readings are prepaid, pre-booked, pre-purchased reading. So when you're sending an SMS to me or a WhatsApp message, please do mention your time zone. And once you book the reading, the delivery will be made within 3 to 4 days of time. There are no ad hoc readings because of prior appointments and prior bookings. I'm going to do your detailed oracle card reading, Leo, for the month of June. And then I'm also going to do your tarot card reading in a while. Let us see what messages do we have in your energies. We have second chakra, Archangel Ariel, and this is about little blockage into your creation, innovation in the month of June. I would also like to admit that when I was reading your card, I was getting a very heavy sense of energy, Leo. I think you need to handle a very difficult situation in the month of June with a lot of courage, and you will witness a major change, a major turmoil. This could be at personal level more for a lot of you, and for very few of you, this is going to be at professional level. There will be a sudden change in a situation which will demand you to handle the situation with courage, not to move into any kind of fear, doubt, anxiety or stress. It will be the moment for you to come into your real power. And Leo, you are known for your courage. So that kind of situation will come to you in front of you in the month of June. I also see that there will be some blockages or things will not be that clear in case you want to create, make something new. You want to innovate something new. So this is the time when you need to relax a bit, work out on your strength, give yourself time and space and take things easily. You know, in the month of June, do take things easily and do not fall into any kind of pressure, or don't feel like controlling things, because things will take its own time in completion, in movement. So just try to have relaxed energy. You also have a card of community which says going out, meeting people, socializing, networking. That is really going to help you. And you have a card of door to romance. In fact, this is the same card we have got for the other fire sign, that is Aries. So yes, this month, the month of June, is going to be a very lucky period for all of you, not just a Leo. It is for all fire signs that the period of June will give you a lot of comfort, lot of resolutions into your love life. Especially there is a spark. Either you are going to meet someone new. I also see that someone professionally is going to get converted into a lifelong partner in your personal life. I also see that there is a reunion if you are away from your partner. And you also have the angel number 976. So I'm going to read the meaning of this number just in a while. Now, when I see this particular card, door to romance, I also feel that if you are meeting a new person in your life, that relationship, that love relationship will be very, very fruitful for you. Rather, when you will move into that relationship, your stars, your planets is really going to support your professional life, your career, your work line. And, you know, you will see materialistic abundance post this particular association. So yes, if you are encountering love with anyone, or if you are feeling for someone that, yes, this is my partner, trust me, the new relationship is going to be very, very prosperous for you. Now, let us see what number meaning do we have for this number. 9, 7 and 6. That's a very, very big number in terms of ending of series. We have 9, 7 and 6, which says you are on the right path with your career and spiritual focus, which ensures that all of your materialistic needs will be met on its own right time at the right place, and you will have the right people surrounding you during that particular time. It's time for you to give that time, that space to divine, to bring the best in front of you at its own divine timing. So just give that time to the nature and see how things are going to come into your favor. Now let us see your messages in the month of June from fairies. You do have a card of pregnancy. This is a good news for people who are looking forward to family extension. Plus, this is also a period wherein if you want to start something of your own, this period is going to be very lucky for you, Leo. It says the birth of a child bring great blessings to you and to the world. I also feel that this is the right time if you want to convert your interest, your hobby, your passion into a small time parallel part-time venture or a business. Please do that because this is the right time to lift up your thoughts and energies. It's time for you to attract what you truly desire with the positive words, positive affirmations, and just trust the power of prayer, because that will open up unexpected routes for you to reach to your dream. And yes, this is definitely a good period for you. It says ask for what you want. So what I am sensing from your reading that you want multiple things. So you either you need to prioritize or you need to make a sequence. Rather, I would say choose one thing out of your whole list which you feel is something you desperately need, you want, you desire. And that one thing can replace all your other priorities, your vision, desire. I would like to suggest you to have a focused intention, because then you are going to attract with all the powers in the divine to attract that particular thing, one thing. Because if you're working on multiple focus, the energy will get divided and then you have to focus on multiple things. So this period is good enough to attract your top priority, your top vision, desire. It says let the universe and the other people know what you truly need and desire, because this is the time for you to see the reward, see the, you know, the blessing coming back to you for sure. Now let us see what angel of abundance messages do we have for you. It's time for you to listen to your intuition completely. Listen to your gut feeling in the month of June, because yes, your intuition, your gut feeling is going to be the guiding force during this particular period. And you have a card of take action, but I would like to tell you, take action when you are absolutely clear, when you are sorted, when you are very sure that yes, this is the path I want to move on. This is the way I want to move on. Choose, but choose wisely. Take your time. There is no hurry. There is no rush in any kind of movement. And you have the other card of angel message, unlikely. Yes, I don't. That is why I told you that you need to decide your priorities. Because if you are expecting 10 things to come to you at one shot, that is not going to happen in the month of June. But yes, if you are focusing on one major aspect, I'm very sure you're going to come very, very close to it. Now let us see what messages do we have in your first 15 days, and I'm going to pull out the cards for the first 15 days for my dear Leo people out there. Yes, you have the card of High Priestess. Something very important will come up at the surface level. The hidden facts, the hidden truth will come out. Wait for that period. That is going to be very important. That information, that piece of information is going to be very important for you to take the decision. Now this card also tells you that, you know, if something is hidden, you need to trust your intuition, your gut feeling, rather than inquiring from 10 other people or being vocal about it. You have Eight of Wands. Yes, a very positive period when all the scattered energy are going to get collected into one and things are going to move forward and upward. Now, when I see this card closely, I do see that there is still a lot of hard work which is there. Now, maybe I'm giving you a very broad time period when I'm seeing this card for you. But I do feel that you still need to work very hard for another 2 to 3 years till the time you reach to the kind of name, fame, and shine into your life you are waiting for. However, during this hard work period, you will keep on getting good opportunities. You will keep on getting the prosperity, the growth you want, but the kind of fame you want in this particular lifetime, Leo, that is going to take a period of 2 to 3 years, to even some of you to even 4 to 5 years. Don't feel bad or don't feel disappointed with this or demotivated with that period, because that much time you need into your life to reach to that spark of name and fame. The card is giving you an extraordinary information this particular time. And your other card for the first 15 days is again the Hermit. That is why when we had an angel message out here, take action. I told you still, though it's an angel message, but I always trust my intuition, my gut feeling more than the cards or my angel communication or my sense of energies of the card, that you need to do a lot of work before taking any major action or any conscious call. Don't invest this particular month. Don't buy property this particular month. Don't buy any asset. I don't see that you will be taking that decision so quickly, because you need to get more information and look at your card. In the first 15 days, you have a Hermit card which says do self introspection. It is the card of actually no movement. It says that look within, look around, do a lot of homework, do a lot of self introspection, and then take a call. And even I would suggest you to take a decision that yes, you will be doing that, but the final action you need to delay by a month or so. Now let us see what advice do we have in the first 15 days. You have Page of Cup. So yes, you will get a relevant message, phone call, email, or a message of the information probably in the first 15 days, which will be very helpful for you in finalizing the kind of decision you want to make, or it may impact or influence your decision accordingly. So just hold on that particular time and things will get resolved on its own in the first 15 days. Now let us see what messages do we have in the second part of June. And we have a card of here comes the Libra strong energy, the energy of the Empress, the comfort, the luxury, the triumph, the flexibility, the resolution comes to you by June. And I do feel period post 18th or 20th of June is going to be very lucky for you. And you have Three of Wands. So if you see, and you have Magician at the bottom. Now if you see, there is a sudden change post mid of June. Suddenly things are shifting towards a very, very positive note. If you see the whole of the month, the first 15 days are talking about taking a halt, taking a introspection. But then the last 15 days will help you in finalizing what you have planned, what kind of strategy you have made. This could be personal, this could be professional. But yes, your second part is more supportive for whatever decision you want to take in near future. And you have Five of Wands. So if you see the last 15 days, things are moving positive. But yes, you might witness competition, difference of opinion, difference of thought at workplace, with people, with peers. Don't fall into conflict. Don't fall into a disagreement up to the extent of fighting or major turmoil at your workplace. If you feel that yes, you are able to share your thoughts, you are being vocal about it, people are accepting it, people are acknowledging it, it's fine. Otherwise, don't be aggressive or don't push your point up to the extent of leading to a conflict or a major disagreement or an unpleasant situation. I do feel that probably by June end at your workplace, you might, or in the last week of June, you might witness something which you will not like that it would have happened with you. So you need to avoid that situation completely. And your last card, the suggestion card for the last 15 days we have from Tarot is Ace of Swords. Yes, there is a new fight communication. Now this is for the first time with Ace of Swords. I do feel that there are new communications happening, but I do see sparks of conflict. I do see sparks of major fight in your life. This could be personal, this could be professional. I'm talking precisely in the June last week. By any means you avoid that, because that is going to cut you, that is going to harm you in the longer run, and that is not going to be into your favor. And that is why I'm repeating it time and again. Just avoid that particular period of, let's say, from June 18th to 30th of June. And then things are absolutely beautiful for you during the rest of the month, and even better for you once you cross this particular period. So just be mindful of this small suggestion which is coming up so clearly and loudly into your reading for the last 15 days. Now let us see what message do we have from the crystal oracle, and which crystal is going to be lucky for you during this period. And we have a card of Dolomite. It says, stay strong in your faith. A positive outcome is actually dependent on you keeping a positive mindset for yourself. So just trust your prayers. Just trust your affirmations and you will see miracles for sure. Now let us see your messages for the month of June. And you already have a flyer which says, victory you desire is coming to fruition. Keep up the good work that you are actually doing for the whole month. And your other card says, yes, the timing is right for this new venture. You already have a card of pregnancy out here, which is not just a message of birth of a child in a family, but it is also a message for a new venture coming up. A happy outcome is going to follow your positive affirmations for your support. And your last card from the messages of angels is, I am the angel of abundance. You will receive the money that you need, and God is in charge of how that will happen. Have faith. Now you have got multiple cards which are telling you to stay in a positive frame of mind, and somebody needs to hear it desperately. If you are waiting for a certain amount, certain money to reach you, please know that whatever you need at the moment is reaching you in no time, because it's the duty of God to see how things are going to happen and how that money, that peace, that amount is going to reach to you to fulfill your need. Now let us pull out your last set of cards, that is your angel therapy, needed angel therapy for the period of June. And you have a card of, you are profoundly clairvoyant. It says, trust what you see in your mind's eye as well as with your physical sight, for your spiritual vision helps you with healing, teaching and guidance. And your other card of the reading is, time for you to cut the cords. Ask Archangel Michael to clear any old attachment to fear that stem from past relationship, freeing you from destructive patterns, the repeated patterns occurring into your life. You know, the patterns which are bothering your mental peace, your emotional well-being, your spiritual development, those are the patterns you need to come out of it in the lifetime. And people do a lot of past life regression therapy, but even if you are aware about it consciously, you can do that. It is just that how you're making yourself aware about it, how you're accepting the reality, and what actions you're willing to take in order to move out from these patterns consciously. And your last card of the reading is vegetarian. It's time for you to pay attention to your diet. Fresh organic fruits and vegetables give you a boost of high life force energy, which are going to elevate your spiritual frequency. So yes, it's also the time for you to uplift your spiritual thoughts and vibrations to bring that awareness into your life. Leo, I really enjoyed doing your reading. Do let me know how you resonated with your reading this time. I will see you next time very soon. Be blessed.